So it's a little noisy. We're in my backyard because I need the floor. I don't want to ruin my wood floors. You won't be wearing tap shoes. Anything but sneakers really works. You want to be able to slide your foot. Sneakers will stick too much. So in the next few days, I'm going to give you little segments. You're going to repeat each segment a few times so that you kind of master the step and then move on to the next. Tap dancing is a rhythmic activity. It can be aerobic. It can increase your memory. It kind of handles some brain fog issues. It's great for balance and coordination. So it's a great thing to learn. Basics of tap dance. There are three parts of your foot. There's the ball of your foot, there's the heel of your foot, and there's the toe, which is the tip of your toe. When you're doing an exercise, you'll hear me say things like ball change. We'll learn that later. So, what's tap dancing? It's a series of rhythms that happen in a timely fashion. So we're always going to count to eight. In a rhythmic pattern. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Basic step of tap dance is a shuffle. I'm going to show it to you forward and then I'm going to show it to you sideways. So, from the knees, you bend, pick your foot up in the back. Your foot is not pointed, it's not flexed, it's relaxed. You're going to take your foot and you're going to brush the ball of your foot forward and then you're going to pull it backwards. It's all from the knee. We're not swinging our whole leg. We're just from our knee. Front, back. Front, back. Front, back. Front, back. Let's try the other foot. You always want to be a two-sided dancer. Never want to just concentrate on one. So pick up your foot. Again, not pointed, not flexed. Just relaxed. And front, back. Front, back. Front, back. Front, back. Shuffle, two sounds, front and back. So it takes two counts. 1, 2. As we learn to do it faster and more efficient, it might take up one and it'll be and one. But then we have to worry about our ankles. We're not up to that point yet. Most tap dancing is actually gonna be involving your knees and your ankles. Your ankles have to work really hard. When you wanna go really fast, you've gotta make it really small. But we're not up to that. So we're gonna face the side, we're gonna do seven shuffles. Step, turn around, do seven more. Ready? 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Turn around. Pick up your other foot. 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I'm balanced. You could do it holding onto a chair or holding onto a countertop. One thing about tap is when you're learning, you learn flat with your heels on the floor. But for the most part, when we start making combinations, you're always going to tap dance on your toes up in row of A so that you're ready to do something that says heel. If your heel's on the floor, it takes an extra count to get it up, and you don't want that to happen. So, first step, shuffle. Second step, shuffle. Toe. Now we talked about the difference between the ball and the toe. The shuffle takes part with the ball of our foot. This is going to make three sounds. 1, 2, 3. Pick it up. 1, 2, 3. Pick it up. Try it with the other side. Foot up in the back. 1, 2, 3. Pick it up. 1, 2, 3. Pick it up. I will say if you're wearing socks, make sure you're not hitting the toe too hard on the ground. So let's do the same thing we did before. This is gonna count a little different. If I was counting this, I would count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Turn around. Ready, and. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now, listen to the difference. If I'm shuffling properly, you can hear a clear toe scuff forward and back. If your heel is hitting the floor, it sounds very clunky. You have to try really hard to separate that ball of the foot and the heel as you're doing your shuffles and keep that heel off the floor. So far we've learned just going to teach us about some weight transfer. So we're going to put our feet apart and we're going to pick up our right heel. And all we're going to do is as we put the right heel down, we're going to pick up the left heel. So they're happening at the same time. So at some point, both my heels are off the floor. Again, great balance activity. We're going to do it slow and then quick. So 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Again, 2, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now we're going to do it faster. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Again, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Balance is so important, and learning to transfer your weight is very important because there's going to be a lot of times you're going to step and use the other foot, and you have to learn where your balance point is on that foot so that you can do it when you're not holding on. So one little review. First step we learned today was shuffles, two sounds, ball of your foot, front and back, foot up, shuffle, turn around, try the other side again, foot up. Shuffle, turn around. Second step we learned was shuffle toe, which is in the back. Ready and shuffle toe. Turn around, try the other foot. Shuffle toe. And the last we learned was a heel drop. So we picked up one heel and we transferred our weight back and forth from heel to heel. Slow at first and then faster. Great job. Keep practicing those steps. Tap lesson number two. I hope you've practiced tap lesson number one several times and you are proficient at a shuffle. Shuffle, two sounds, front and back, from the knee, a little bit of ankle, not too hard. We're going to do shuffles before we start the next step, but this time we're going to go a little faster. I talked about doing them with an end one count opposed to a 1-2 count. So we're going to do 7 shuffles and turn a little faster. A 5, 6, 7, 8. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Turn around, foot up. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Turn front. Good job. So that's something to do a few times so that you can build up your speed for your shuffles. We did shuffle toe, which our toe, remember, is the tip of our shoe, and we did shuffle toe. Today we're going to learn shuffle hop. Now everybody wants to hop. If you don't want to hop, it is completely acceptable to pick your heel up and put it down. So you'd be doing shuffle heel, but we're going to do shuffle hop. Same thing. Here's where that balance comes in. Use a chair, use a counter until you get proficient. Like I said, we're going to do it flat-footed, but eventually, 6 videos from now, we're going to be doing it on our toe, and you're going to have to be able to balance after you hop and keep your foot. But we're going to do it flat for today. So, shuffle hop. Same premise. Foot back. From the knee. Shuffle. When it gets to the back, hop. It takes 3 counts. 1, 2, 3. Hold. 1, 2, 3. Try the other side. Foot to the back. I'm going to do it with the heel this time. Back and forth 7 times and switch. A 5, 6, 7, 8. Shuffle, hop. 4, 5, 6, 7. Change sides. This time I'm going to do heel so you can see the difference. 6, 7, 8. Shuffle, heel. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Good. All right, so shuffle heel, that's our new step. 3 sounds for a shuffle heel. Once you master that shuffle heel, you can put the shuffle heel together with a shuffle heel toe. So basically we're doing combinations now. That's going to take 4 sounds. I actually think it's a little easier to do shuffle heel toe because if you can put your toe down, it gives you a little more balance. It's shuffle, hop, tap. 4, shuffle, from the beginning all together. Four, seven, five, six, seven, eight, one. Ha, toe, shuffle. Ha, toe, three, four, five, six, seven. Turn around. Ready? Other side. A five, six, seven, eight. Shuffle. Shuffle hop toe. We've altered it a little bit for people that can't hop because you have bad knees or hips, and do a heel instead. Our new step and our last step we're going to learn today is a ball change. The ball of our foot is this part again. So a ball change is just two steps. Ball change. So we start with our right, right, left. Start with your right, right, left. Now what makes it a ball change is that weight transfer we were talking about last time that we did with our heels. Now we're gonna weight transfer with our toes. So we're gonna step back on our right foot on the ball, so my heel is up, and step forward on the left foot with my heel up. So it's gonna look like this. Ball change, ball change, ball change, ball change. Try the other side. Right, the left foot is going back. Ready, and ball change, ball change, ball change, ball change. Where would you see a ball change, you ask? We can do a shuffle ball change. Shuffle, ball change. We'll learn that next time. But that's why we do our weight transfers. They either help us to change feet mid-combination, or they help it so that we can use up more time in a four count. So that would be one, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. So let's do our ball changes. We're going to do seven this way. Turn and do seven the other. Five, six, seven, eight. Ball change. Ball change. And three. And four. And five. And six. And seven. Turn around. Right foot back. Change, you have to do it on your toes. You have to balance. It would be flat foot if we did it, and it wouldn't be the right step if we did this one flat footed. So you have to do it up on your toes and you have to balance. So definitely time to use a chair or a countertop. So review for today. We did shuffle hop, shuffle hop, turn around, shuffle hop, shuffle. We did shuffle, hop, toe, shuffle, hop, toe, shuffle, hop, toe, turn around, shuffle, hop, toe, shuffle, hop, toe. And our weight transfer activity today was a ball change. Back, front, back, front, back, front. Other side. Lesson number three, tap dancing. So you always wanted to learn how to tap dance. So, lesson one concentrated on shuffles, two sounds, balancing. By now you've done lesson one several times, lesson two a few times, so those shuffles should be really proficient and you should be able to balance, and try taking them up on your toes now so that you don't have to keep the heels on the floor. It's the same principle. We learned our weight transfer activities over the week, which was the heel transfer, and then it faster, and our ball transfer, which is a ball change, ball change. We've done shuffles, shuffle toes, shuffle hop toes. So today, we're gonna do something different. Our weight transfer activity today is going to be shuffle. How do you do that. Shuffle, step. Now, again, we're gonna do them flat-footed, so there may be an extra sound in there, but as I go through it, I'm gonna go up onto releve on my toes, and I'm gonna do some on my toes so you can hear the difference. So, when you shuffle step, shuffles can be done in multiple directions. Shuffles can be done to the front, they can be done to the side, they can also be done to the back. Back's hard, you have to plie, you have to bend your knee, you really have to use your ankle. We're not going to do that yet. But we are gonna shuffle just a little bit to the side today. So, my toes are gonna turn out a little bit, but I'm gonna keep my feet relatively parallel, and as I pick my foot up, I'm gonna turn my knee out a little bit and my foot to the angle I wanna go to, which is kind of the corner. It's not directly to the side, it's out to the corner. So, I'm gonna go shuffle, step, other foot, shuffle, step, other foot, shuffle, step, other foot, shuffle, step. So, like I said, as you learn it and you go a little faster, you're gonna take it up on your toes. It's hard to balance when you're doing it slow. So as you get more comfortable with the shuffles, slowly rise up onto your toes, it'll be much easier. Otherwise, holding onto a chair or holding onto a countertop. So we're gonna do 16 shuffles, flat-footed right now. Hands on hips, starting, remember, parallel feet, but as I pick up, it's slowly gonna go to the side. If you're having a hard time going to the side, just as acceptable to go forward. Ready? Up 5, 6, 7, 8. And 1, and 2, and 3, and 4, and 5, and 6, and 7, and 8, and 9, and 10, 11, and 12, and 13, and 14, and 15, and 16. Now notice, I did that exercise a little bit faster because you've been practicing so much on the first one, our shuffles should be great. I'm gonna slow it down a little bit this time so that if anybody was having a hard time with that, they can do the slower version. We're only gonna do 8 this time. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Good job. So, the slower one is also good for you to practice doing it up on your toes. Let's try, I'm just gonna show you once. Up 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Good. All right, guys. It's a little hard with the crevices in my deck. I keep getting stuck. I apologize. So that's our weight transfer today. It was actually our shuffles. We're going to go back to our ball change, another weight transfer activity, and we're going to do heel to the front and then ball change. So it's the same foot to start the exercise. So we're going to start with our right foot. We're going to put our right foot forward, and then we're going to pick up that right foot and step back, front. Right foot again, heel, ball, change. Heel, ball, change. Right foot, ball, change. Right foot, ball, change. Right foot, ball, change. Right foot, ball, change. Okay, let's try that other foot now, everybody. Ready? Right foot. Right foot goes back, front. Right foot goes back, front. Right, ball, change. Right, ball, change. Right, ball, change. Right, ball, change. Now, we're trying to balance, so yes, you might have to drop that heel down when you do your ball change so that you can balance with your heel up, but if you're holding on, you should be able to go heel, ball, change. Heel, ball, change. Heel, ball, change. Ball change and not put your heels down. Great. Last new step for this episode is fallap. Fallap is also a two sound step, but the difference between a fallap and a shuffle, a fallap goes in the same direction for both sounds. So your foot starts just like a shuffle, it makes a brush just like a shuffle, and then it taps down in the front. So, 1, 2, Ready, and rush down. Rush down. A little faster. One, two, one, two, one, two, one, two. Remember, let's keep those heels off the floor. We don't want that clunky. We want to hear a nice, clean ball of your foot brushing down. So let's do seven and step, and seven and step. Five, six, seven, eight. And one, and two, and three, and four, and five, and six, and seven. Step, switch feet. And one, and two, and three, and four, and five, and six, and seven. Step. Falafel is going to be a very useful step. It can be done staying in place. It can be done with a ball change. It can be done with a heel. It can be done traveling, which means to move, which means you're going to have to stay on your toes and transfer your weight. We'll learn that another time. Let's review what we learned today. Our first weight transfer activity was shuffle step, hands on your hips, shuffle a little bit to the side, step, changing sides. Like I said, you can put your heels down while you're learning it. But eventually, you're going to want to bring it up on your toes and try to balance. You can definitely do that holding on to a countertop. Our second weight transfer that we did today was heel ball change. We did our heel, the same foot steps back, front, heel, back, front, heel, back, front. Try the other side, heel, back, front, heel, front, heel, back, front. And the last step we learned today was a falafel. Two sounds, same direction. Brush front, touch down. Brush front, touch down. Brush down, brush down, brush down. Try the other side. Brush down, brush down, brush down. Great job, everybody. Keep practicing. Videos one, two, and three. You're doing a great job.